Milia, otherwise known as milk spots, appear on the face as multiple white globoid papules, looking like this. So close to the cell surface, bulging out but not yet surfacing. And for the most part, they're usually grouped together on the nose, cheeks, and chin. And a lot of the times it happens to newborns, but adults can experience them too. In this video, we will look at the best treatment for milia, as well as how to prevent them from coming back. So let's get started. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as being in the know when it comes to your health and wellness, and I would love for you all to gently tap on the like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Also, if you guys are on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's dive right in. Milia are tiny cysts that form under the skin, usually on the face. And for the most part, they're just a cosmetic issue. So the choice to treat them or not is entirely up to you. Some decide to keep them and embrace them, while some do everything they can to get rid of them. Whatever method you decide to treat it with, I urge you not to try to pop them. Even though they look like whiteheads and can be so tempting to pop, they won't pop. That's because they're actually cysts, and you digging your nails into them are going to increase the risk of infection and worse, scarring. And in case you're wondering how on earth did they get there in the first place, a lot of times they form from long-term sun exposure, believe it or not, the overuse of topical steroids, and cigarette smoking. So what do you do? Well, the first treatment option on our list is going to be products that increase cell turnover. Why? Because we want to influence our own skin to push it out closer to the surface. Give the skin a little boost. If the milia is here, we want to get it up there. So we need to use products that are going to do this. Salicylic acid, glycolic acid, and adapalene can help depending on how close the milia is sitting underneath the surface of the skin. If it's deeper, then of course it's going to take longer to treat. And you might be in the need of a stronger agent, which is the second treatment option. Topical retinoids, which we know will exfoliate the skin more effectively than your typical over-the-counter products. They also loosen the keratin plug in milia, helping it come to the surface and go away. This usually is done either with tretinoin or tazarotene, which do need a prescription from your dermatologist. The third treatment is an oral antibiotic known as minocycline, but this is only for those severe cases of milia called milia in plaque, which happens more frequently in women 40 to 60. The milia, what ends up happening is they clump together on a raised patch of skin, usually behind your ears or on your jaw. And lastly, the fourth treatment is an in-office procedure with your dermatologist. Usually what they can do is make a small incision into the skin and gently pull out the milia plugs, and you'll be on your way. Sometimes, but not always, they would need to use cryotherapy too, using very cold temperatures from liquid nitrogen to freeze it off the skin. And if that doesn't work, what they can also do is laser ablation and resurfacing, which uses small lasers to remove them. Now, I know I'm going to get asked, what about just poking it at home? You don't even want to attempt doing this to your skin. If you have an unsteady hand or feel uncomfortable about it, it's not worth messing up and damaging your skin just doing it at home this way. Secondly, if you have many concentrated milia spots in one area rather than one or two areas, this constitutes a more complicated case. And lastly, don't want to attempt to remove it on your own, especially if you have milia under the eyes or on the eyelids. You don't want to have a serious risk of harm to the eye. It's better to go in and get it done if that's the case, if they are on your eyelids or anywhere near your eye for that matter. And when it comes to milia prevention, let's say after you successfully have had them removed, sun protection is going to be your best friend. You need to protect your skin from the sun moving forward because subsequent sun damage will make it more difficult for cells to rise to the skin's surface where they need to be and shed normally. Broad spectrum SPF 30 or more, reapply it every 2 hours. I like the Super Goop Unseen Super Transparent one, doesn't have a white cast and glides on like butter, which I've left a link down below for it. Secondly, besides the sunscreen, is use a gentle exfoliant at least twice a week. This will ensure your skin is moving upward to the surface, not getting stuck along the way down in the crevices. The 2% BHA liquid exfoliant by Paula's Choice is my current favorite one. It works amazing, especially for acne prone skin, and I've made a video all about that product right here, which you can watch as well. Hit that subscribe button below if you found any value in this video, and comment down below as well what your thoughts are on Milia, because I know it can be frustrating treating it, and I'd like to hear from you. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.